It's Friday, we got mascots, and you're here to judge them for all that they are. Hi everyone, congrats, we made it through another week, and we are here to ring in the weekend the only way we know how, with TurboDuo Mascot Platformers.
You gotta love it!
No poll this week, because we have unfinished business.
Sure do.
If you saw Wednesday's stream, we got about halfway through Camp California, featuring the official mascots of the Beach Boys. Then the game crashed, refused to play anymore. So, in a blind rage, I threatened everyone to do a one-credit clear of this game tonight. That's happening right now, supposedly.
Thank you, Danny Dinohart, for 13 months subscription. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Sorry, I'm still kind of reeling from the dinosaur, dino gore. The dino damage, Jesus.
Magical Dinosaur Tour is the only TurboGrafx-16 game that I own. It is the only TurboGrafx-16 CD game I own, and it has paid off so much.
It's kind of awful, but I love you.
Every time we do a Mascot Friday, I can count on it to deliver some unexpected gore.
Just something awful every time.
Anyway, yeah, Camp California crashed on us, and in a blind rage, I threatened to do a one-credit clear. Now, at the time, I had never actually done a one-credit clear of Camp California. But on the other hand, this entire stream is predicated on my mouth writing checks that my ass later has to cash.
Sorry about your ass.
And right now, it's time to pay the piper, my ass. I gotta play some Camp California.
They have a picture of your ass up at the gas station, and they're like, do not accept his checks.
Do not give gas to this ass.
Happy Great Friday! Start.
All right, so Mascot Friday rules apply. Everything you see tonight, you are later going to vote on. So as you see these games, think about whether they are better or worse than Bubsy, and then you'll be able to let your voice be heard. In addition to Camp California, we're also doing unfinished business with Tailspin, which wasn't working the last time people voted it in. I managed to get a working ROM, which according to Good Set is a bad ROM. That's right, the Turbo Flash Cart will only play a bad ROM of Tailspin.
Oh. Good.
And then we'll finish things up with another icon platformer, Shapeshifter. So a whole lot of funny animal platformers we're playing tonight. Let's get started.
Hooray.
Time for my ass to cash a check. That's how that works, right?
Take your ass down to the payday loan, people.
Ah, they say my ass needs an ID.
Wow. They're judgmental. All right, I think I need to still got it.
Alright, so, I did do a couple of runs of this last night, and I did indeed do my first one-credit clear. We had a lot more to say about this on Wednesday, but we're foregoing the history lesson this time. In favor of me beating this game to a pulp.
Yeah, all you need to know is that this is based on a never-released, never-produced Beach Boys cartoon.
Let's listen. Byron Bear, nothing he can't do. He's a cool bear daddy.
You didn't even go through the whole thing. You're like, nope, he's just a cool bear daddy.
That's all I needed to hear.
Okay.
Let's start the game.
It's Friday.
So I mentioned before, this game only gives you one continue, but fuck that. We don't need any continues.
Not us.
I figured out a new route through this game. You can unlock the best character early, and if you do that, a lot of the levels become trivial. Round, round, get around, I get around. Still have the threat of VOD muting due to the extensive Beach Boys soundtrack, by which I mean it plays Beach Boys songs on the map and the character select.
And then during the game it plays stuff from the network. the network music ensemble.
I really enjoy this game except for the way it actually plays. Everything about it I really enjoy.
So you like the game but you hate playing it.
I wouldn't even say that. I mean, I've played worse.
Fucking Pogus.
Maybe by the end of today, this game will seem pretty good compared to what else we play. That's my hope, anyway. So, to recap from Wednesday, we play as Byron the Bear, who is the stand-in for Brian Wilson of the Beach Boys. Again, not making that up, that's a thing that happened. So, his bandmates have been captured, and their instruments were taken, and we gotta find them all.
There goes that guy.
Uh-huh. You start off as Byron, who's a big stupid bear. All he can do is punch things.
And say Pogus when he gets hit.
And every time he gets hit, he engages the plosives on his cheap microphone. So he says Pogus. I try to show off more of this game than the last time. You'll see some bonus content. Go ahead.
I was going to say, this is definitely a Friday stream with the subject matter here with the inflating rats and the bear daddy.
Oh, yeah. It's all very on brand.
Those muscle fucking birds?
Muscle birds.
I don't know how I feel about them.
All the skeletons, all the kids being turned to skeletons. No, that's
just that's Yo Bro.
That's just an ICOM thing.
All right, no kids are turned into skeletons in this game, right?
Not that we've seen.
We warned you.
We discussed on the Discord a couple days ago that ICOM simulations, they may just have skeletons and skeletonization as a recurring theme. Because if you'll remember, they started off with The Uninvited, which is a game where one of the first things you interact with and get killed by is a skeleton lady. And then a skull shows up to tell you that you died.
Well, you know, that makes sense.
And since then, they've continued their love affair with skeletons. Except not literally, I hope.
Damn me! Happy fucking Friday!
That would be pogus.
Be very pogus.
I'm looking forward to never seeing this stupid fucking bear again. I want to beat this game and have it be done.
Be nice to Byron. He's been through some shit.
That's true.
Made an entire movie about it. It's called Byron's Bogus Journey.
I love that that kick didn't actually do anything, because I caught him in his attacking frame, and he's invincible during that.
This music sounds like the local news sports report. Yes, yes. We talked about Network Music Ensemble on the Wednesday stream, but it's a, basically this is music made to be licensed for TV and for your background music. Disney used it a lot for the Disney Channel back in the 80s, especially for DTV. And you hear it a lot. I heard one of these songs in my car commercials. It's fucking great.
Yeah, odds are good that if you watch TV in the 80s and 90s, you may recognize some of these tracks. Byron controls like a bear. He controls like a bear in sunglasses.
Doing good.
Oh, shit. Oh, well, that's fine.
Okay, you're good. Just take that guy to death. Oh, very close.
That was cool.
Yeah, that is the song that plays. That is the anthem of Truck Month, I should say. Not Trunk Month.
I guess I'll still let the cutscenes play out, because to most people, they're still pretty novel.
They're the best. There are some of the best parts of the game.
Oh, look at him tip his sunglasses right at the right moment. What a dipshit. Anyway.
Danny, be nice.
I gotta be nicer to this bear.
I don't know if Byron is a fight or die of bears. He doesn't seem like much of a queer icon. But if you want to make Byron the bear of Camp California a queer icon, please have at it.
Oh, by all means. So we mentioned on Wednesday, the best mechanic in this game is the gas mechanic. The map you have to navigate around, a la Super Mario Bros. 3, takes gas to navigate. So in each level you have to pick up a shit ton of garbage, which is converted into magic gasoline for your Woody.
I should mention that specifically all these Network Music Ensemble songs are from one specific album called After School Rock, and it's on YouTube. And it's not good.
It's not pogus. I wouldn't call it great, but I wouldn't call it pogus
either. It's not pogus, you're right. I say it's not good, it's actually pretty good, but you know, if you...
They're catchy.
You can close your eyes and imagine the 90s TV landscape in front of you. Oh, good, you have your sunglasses back on your icon.
Yeah. Now, the important thing is to remember where all the 1-ups are, because, boy, this game loves draining your lives. Because in the map sequence, if you run out of gas and you don't have reserve tanks, it starts taking away your lives as payment. And then your continues. So that's cool. At some point in the run, we're going to have to eat a couple of lives for gas. I'm conflicted about that.
Ass, gas, or lives.
Uh-huh. No one rides for free. Not in the Woody, that's for sure. I talk a lot of shit about this game, but honestly, I kind of enjoy it. I get a perverse enjoyment out of this game.
That's a way to say that.
Yeah. Rephrase that so it doesn't sound bad.
Danny gets a sick, twisted light out of this.
I get a naughty surge from playing this game. Yeah, that's better.
Perfect. Good.
Honestly, I used to worry about losing lives in the first level, but then I realized the game doesn't replenish your health, so you're not really gaining anything by conserving your health or anything. It's just constantly draining. Didn't even think of that as a lake of piss until people pointed it out.
Well, that's because our chat, as wonderful as they are, they're also... you're sometimes...
They know disgusting. Piss when they see it.
They sure fucking knew, and they will let us know. How is that fucking fair?
Yeah, it's not. You can't really punch all of those notes.
They're like it generated by notes.
Alright, we found the first instrument. In the most undramatic way possible. It's very easy to miss the instruments because the game doesn't really point them out.
You know, I haven't listened to Yellow River Boys, but Danny, we should do that. That's Tim Heidecker's piss-themed band.
Oh yeah, we should. I like his Decker music. Sing songs about America. He's basically the Beach Boys of the modern era.
Danny, stop! I can't believe I married a Tim Head.
I'm just saying, I relate. There's always some so-called expert trying to ruin your show.
Oh man, it's RPM.
Oh yeah, your favorite song.
This is my favorite piece of a production music. I fucking love this piece. Oh, basically fake Blondie, I think someone pointed out during
it is.
Yeah.
It just straight up steals the Call Me riff. But how can you be mad when the song is this good?
I can't be mad. Even when you're getting your ass kicked by all these rats.
These goddamn rats.
What is with us and our rat curse? We are rat cursed.
At some point during any stream, we're going to be devoured by rats.
Listen.
Metaphorically.
I mean, it's got to happen sometime.
Logan. Damn, specifically trying to avoid that dog. That's okay. Whoa, okay. Let's make this jump. There we go, we made it this time.
Hooray.
If you make that jump, around half the number of things that fall on your head usually will fall on your head. You're still gonna take a couple of hits here, though. No, clean!
Man,
we did it clean!
Congrats!
I was so tempted to turn this into a speedrun. I don't know why I didn't. Probably because I still wanted to show off the story and things.
The story's interesting. I mean, I don't know if the story is interesting, but seeing all the failed Beach Boys cartoon characters talk is interesting.
Yeah, it does give the only context into what Camp California was going to be. Before it was apparently scuttled or whatever.
Yeah, I wonder why that... I'm assuming they just had issues or something and that's why it never came out. But it got pretty far, I guess. I mean, it had an album and everything.
But like you said during your lecture at the top of Wednesday's show, like, there were so many opportunities for them to turn the Beach Boys into a cartoon and they almost did it like 5 different times.
They did! I'm still kind of sad that it never, like, went through, but, you know. We sure have all those other great cartoons, like, the Archies and,
The Beatles. The Beatles cartoon is kind of amazingly shit. I kind of like it.
Kelly! Man, I'm glad I found you.
Me too! Thanks, Byron! Look, Shred is inside that heap of junk! You've gotta get him out!
No problem, Kel. I'll get Shred, and maybe you can fix the Woody!
Did that thing break down again?
Yeah. What else is new?
All right, you get Shred and I'll take care of fixing the Woody. Good luck!
I love this.
Yeah.
Again, from Wednesday, you have to hit run to advance after the cutscenes, otherwise the characters will just stare at each other forever.
Chat loves Woodies.
This level's bad. This may be one of the hardest levels in the game. Mostly because they make you play as Byron, who is a big, clumsy bear. He's not like Cool Duck, but we'll get in a second.
Is it my favorite boy?
Yeah.
Oh, it's a little asshole!
I think his name is supposed to be Thrash, but...
Is it Thrash or Shred?
It's one of those. Who fucking knows?
Wow. why is there lava in the sewer? Because everyone's eating spicy food.
Look, they got this. They got this story direct from the Beach Boys.
Yes.
They had their own reasons.
Ask Mike Love. Just do it. Go find his house and yell at him about Camp California.
Ask him about Hotel California while you're at it. I'm sure he loves to be asked stupid questions.
Just ask him a bunch of... Just find my glove and ask him the stupidest questions possible.
Logan.
You're gonna take a lot of damage here regardless, so... It's best to just tank it. Well, we got lucky there.
Logan.
Overall, this is an extremely lucky run.
I was gonna say, this is a lot better.
Yeah, I didn't have six lives here last, on Wednesday.
I forgot about Partridge Family 220 AD.
Shredhead! You okay, man?
Shred.
Yeah, and I'm ready to take out some of those totally evil rats.
Sounds good. Let's get out of here, huh?
Yeah, let's go.
So one of these characters is Nancy Cartwright, and I can't really pick out her role. It's tough.
Little asshole.
Little asshole. That's the name we've given him. Huey, Dewey, Louie, and Shred.
I'm Shred! And I'm a little piece of shit!
Wow, it's like he's right here with us.
That's right, Danny, I'm never leaving!
Oh god, you sound like you're dying. Alright, now last time around, we skipped this level because this is supposed to be one of the last levels you do because it's really tough. But if you have Little Asshole in your party, you can do it right now. And that'll save a lot of trouble in the long run. So, Little Asshole, this is your time to shine.
Gonna get a pack of new ports and have a good time!
In fact, you need him to progress through this level. Eventually, there's an overhang where none of the other characters can progress except for him. He spins around for exactly 2 seconds, and then he stops in place, ruining any momentum you had. It's not ideal. But he's not total shit like Little Brother is.
I still love his jump. It's the most perfect jump in the entirety of video games.
It's good. They didn't even have to draw any extra animation frames.
He just made him twirl towards the future. We get that one up.
We want that one up for sure. By the way, this part is way more easily done with the other characters because they jump higher and have better controls. But if you complete this part and get to the next part, you can't progress. And you have to backtrack back to the Woody. And waste a ton of gas getting back to where you were. This is a good game. And this is the part you can't get past unless you're Little Asshole.
Little Asshole Bates, I've decided.
He probably does. That's what's ruining his voice. So this level's a bunch of bullshit. It's full of a whole bunch of enemies you can't see until they hit you, which is always fun. But on the plus side, there's 2 1-ups in this level, which we want to get. Look at that. See that spider there? I bet you didn't.
How are you supposed to fucking see that?
One of the 1-ups is right here.
Well, he didn't vape in 1992, but he vapes now.
Yeah, he switched to vaping.
His doctor told him if he didn't start vaping, he would die. And he was like, well, I need to be alive so I can keep making money. Now he just takes massive rips in like the middle of the store and everyone's like, please, sir. And he's like, it's not illegal. It's not illegal. Sorry.
Always getting you on a technicality. That's a little asshole. It's also probably the biggest map in the game, this one level. It is huge. Ugh.
It's fucking majestic-ass production music.
I know. You could talk shit on production music, but it has a level of polish that really doesn't suit the rest of this game. Which has no polish whatsoever. Then again, I shouldn't say that. We're gonna vote on these games. Maybe the games you see after this will make you better appreciate Camp California's charms.
Fucking jump every goddamn time!
Whee!
Woohoo! Oh, jumping around!
Yes, little asshole is absolutely sorry. Little Shred here. Little asshole Shred is absolutely a sovereign citizen. I'm sorry to anyone who's become emotionally attached to this character, and I'm just ruining him for you. I can't get over him. Yes, he is absolutely barefoot, should be legal. However, he always wears shoes. Don't ask. It's just one of the many contradictions of Lil Shred, the little asshole we all love.
Do we all love him? No. I wasn't part of that vote. I mean, he's good for this level, and I guess for the Area 51 level, but once I get the character in this level, we're pretty much kicking him to the curb.
No, it's not because he likes feet. It's because he's an agent of chaos. That's why.
He is pure chaos.
He isn't. He is absolutely, like, one of those serious... He's one of those dudes who, like, is super into, like, chaos religion or something.
He wants Texas to secede.
He does! And you're like, why? You don't even live here. And he's just like, sounds like a good idea!
What are you gonna do, little asshole? Print your own money? Yeah! It's gonna have me on it.
What a burger will be free! They're gonna serve those taquitos all day now!
One up number two. Up to 9 lives. That's the first time that's ever happened in a run in this game. I think this run is gonna go very well.
Is this like... I forget, who did we figure out that this guy is supposed to be of the Beach Boys? Like...
Well, he's not either Brian or Dennis Wilson. He's one of the others.
So he's either Carl, or maybe he's Bruce, or Mike.
Could be Mike Love. Well...
Well, he's dead now.
It's nice to have those 9 lives when I did. I beat the level!
Hooray!
Alright, now next, we have to fight the evil Canadian Lumberjacks.
Oh my... Oh yeah, this is an ecology-themed game, so... Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, this is, even though we're fighting Canadian Lumberjacks, this is Yosemite Park.
So they're just turning Yosemite into a nightmare factory?
They would, those freaking Canadians.
Fucking...
No! I want to make that platform. Look at this guy.
This seems like such a... Oh my god, this fucking sucks, sweetie.
Yeah. Oof, okay, we made it.
I apologize on behalf of all video games for this.
Here's how you beat these guys. You spin into them, then you pause, then you spin again, you pause, there we go. There's 3 of them.
100 bits from IAS, who says, hearing this music while cruising in American Truck Simulator is surreal.
This is badass trucking music.
Yeah, this is fucking awesome.
Feel free to steal any of these strats you see for your speedrun, if you're planning one. I do want there to be a speedrun of this. It's just... not now. At the very least, I'll have this recorded, so if I ever do want to speedrun it, I'll at least have the data. And with all the Canadians dead, we can get our saxophone.
God, those guys were buff.
Yeah. Oh, that's right, we don't get the hidden character in this area. We get him in a... Okay, no. I forgot the route briefly, but we're good.
We're still good?
Mm-hmm. Okay. The drill pelican we need to pick up in Area 51, which is right near us.
Okay, we're gonna raid it?
Yeah.
Alright.
We're finally doing it. Around, you know, little asshole came up with the Naruto run idea.
Everyone was like, that's stupid. That's useless, little asshole. And he's like, no, it'll work. They can't hit us with the bullets if we run real fast.
And quit calling it the Naruto run. It's the little asshole run.
I copyrighted it myself, see? Submitted the patent right here.
This level's weirdly bare. It's very short compared to the last one. You'll see. Also, we're fighting the U.S. Army at this point. But little asshole could not be happier. Also, this really jolly music. Can't get over it. See, the Area 51 run raid will work if we use this as background music.
Mm-hmm.
Another one up here.
You just have to flip, like, completely. You have to just jump around. Yeah, don't do the Naruto run. Do the little asshole jump where you just spin, where you just spin yourself in a fucking circle.
Keep the same pose while you jump. Do not change poses.
Oh, I see the lawyer in chat, Krunko's mad at me for talking about copyright law incorrectly. Fancy pants.
You're awful cocky for a Friday. Okay, it's Friday.
Listen, you can trademark a patent, and under the DMCA, all your trademarks become patents. It's true. Look it up. It's in the Bible.
Everyone should vape simultaneously to make a smoke screen. That's a good idea.
That's really smart. Oh my god. Oh my god, we've got brain geniuses here.
Now we're thinking. See, we gotta get to Area 51 so we can save our pal, Drill Pelican.
He's gonna be shot in his face!
Just hit and tap. Hit and tap. Real easy. Just turn up the turbo switches on your attack button. Got him. Didn't even take a hit.
Good fucking job. That was really good.
Wee!
Here I go! Also, you don't need to tell me what a Woody is. I grew up in Southern California. I went to the beach. I know what a Woody is. My parents had to have the Woody talk with me.
Hey, Shred. Thanks for getting me out of there, dude.
No problemo, Pouch Man.
That big cheese and his rats are really making me mad. I mean, they're ready to destroy Mom Earth without blinking an eye.
We've got to stop him before he does any more damage.
Well then, let's get to it.
They call me Pouch Man. I think it's just people making fun of my weight. Alright, so in a change from last week's, or rather Wednesday's run, we're not going to head to Vegas. We can skip that entire first Vegas run in favor of going to the underwater level. Because as it turns out, Drillikin, his special ability is swimming. Now we have to sacrifice a life here, because we're going to run out of gas. Otherwise this plan is foolproof. This level's horrible. You can drown, and that instantly takes a life from you.
What?
Our goal is to get through this first part as quickly as possible. I love that Beach Boys song, I.
It's one of my favorites.
Alright, so we want to head to the lower left, but on the way, we want to pick up...
I forgot!
Pick up some air bubbles when we find them. And try not to get hit, because it makes him go, ouch!
No way!
This makes it sound like we have a really grumpy platformer star.
Oh my god, he's turning blue!
Yeah.
Holy shit, he turns blue?
Yeah, he can die.
He
straight up asphyxiates.
Oh my god!
Pretend I pronounced that correctly. Okay, so we're on the bottom of the ocean floor here, so if we swim to the left real... quick-like, we can get to these mysterious teeth.
No, 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 no!
And we can be where we belong, inside a larger creature.
Danny?
Uh-huh.
Danny?
Now don't worry, we have company down here. Here you can see the last person who entered, Pinocchio. He's turned into a wood skeleton, which is kind of weird, but you gotta have a skeleton in this game.
There's Titanic!
Uh-huh. So there's a lot of explosives down here in this derelict ship. You don't want to hit those. There's one box labeled Pepper. It's right next to the drum set, which we needed. And if you let loose the pepper, nothing happens, but something changes up here, even though the game doesn't tell you about it.
I am mad.
About what?
That this game also has fucking Vore.
Is this a surprise?
No, I just...
Something like 3/4 of the games we played on Friday.
When will we be free?
When we've ranked every mascot platformer.
Oh, God. Well, they're horrible mice skeletons. That's cool.
Yeah.
Ouch. Look at the way he died! Oh, my God! That's so grim! So grim! Oh, my God!
That's a good death sprite.
Just kind of
giving up and flopping over.
Welcome, John. This stream is so cursed.
Yeah, every week a new curse. Welcome.
Jesus H.
I'm pretty confident in this run. This is going really well so far. I mean, at the worst, I would still use a continue and we'd see the end, but...
Thank you, Sasquatchulus, for the resub. They say this game is upsetting.
How so? But thank you. When I think of this game,
ouch.
First thing that come to mind is, ouch!
Ouch!
I hate that! Okay, you're alive again. I hate the bloated dead corpse floating. Ouch.
Look, it's necessary. This is an ICOM game. It's all about corpses and skeletons with those guys.
Please get that air!
Alright.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, I don't really like the way he turns blue.
No, it's really upsetting.
That seems just unnecessary. This is ostensibly for kids. It was gonna be a kid's cartoon.
Sorry that I keep making you get the air bubble, demanding you get the air bubbles. I just do not like seeing this bird drown and turn blue.
Is that all of them? Okay, we did it. Yeah. We unlocked the best character in the game.
Who is this?
It's Lanky Bird, who has a name, supposedly.
Pouch! Buddy, man, I thought I was a goner there for sure. Well, that arachnid dweller dude looked mean on the outside, but he was major wimpiness on the inside. Let's go find out what... What did you say, dude? I said, let's go find out what Byron's got planned next. Maybe you should get to Mare first. Then we'll find the Woody and rap with Byron about the plan. Yeah!
We should stop talking underwater somehow.
He sounds like me. I love him.
He's Little Asshole's big brother, so I guess we can call him Big Asshole.
Big Asshole! Wow! Wow!
Alright, so the two worst levels are over with. The rest of this should be smooth sailing.
Friday, I'm in love.
With Big Asshole.
With Big Asshole!
So we're gonna go down here, and we're gonna try to take a detour to the mall. Eat another life there. The mall should give us enough life, or rather gas, to survive our trip to Mexico. Without needing to divert to Nevada.
I want to see...
So...
I love him! What is he doing? What is he doing with his hands?
He's air guitar.
Okay, I thought he was ripping at his flesh.
Okay. Come on. Come on now.
Okay, info from Electric Boogaloo. None of the actors from the Camp California Music City are in this. It uses talent from Minneapolis.
Oh, that's a shame. Okay. Yeah, they had some pretty big names on the soundtrack CD. So look at this guy. Can you see the problem with him? He can fly. None of the other characters can.
I love the way he screams! Oh, it's how I scream. Oh! This
look at his Luigi from Mario 2 jump.
Oh my god!
I like
that.
Oh
my god, his jump is so bad compared to his brothers. I love him.
Now one thing I found out is you can actually beat this level with multiple characters, and the character you rescue at the end, there will be different dialogue depending on which character you pick. They actually went through the effort of doing that.
Oh wow.
So we'll get some exclusive dialogue here.
Alright,
I think the canon way to finish this level is with Byron the Bear, because they get an exclusive you know, just rapping between brothers.
Oh, nice.
Anyway, go on.
Colonel Electric Boogaloo, one of the actors in this was in both Dracula Unleashed and Golden Nugget.
Holy shit. An FMV Renaissance person. I'll just air guitar in front of the elevator. Oh, wait, I don't need to wait for the elevator. I forgot.
Yeah, you can fly.
Yeah. Oh, that's so nice. So if you watched on Wednesday, this level ends with a very frustrating climb up a Lego pyramid, where the blocks are just like a single tile in width, and it's real easy to fall off. That was with a character who couldn't fly. Alright, I see we have fans of the hay!
I love the hay.
Alright, so check this out.
Get some merch of your little brother. Oh, this is just...
Look at this shit. You see this?
This is so fucking trivial. You're not, uh-huh. You're not even grabbing the garbage.
No, fuck that. I'm no garbage collector.
What is this? Oh my god.
Trivializes it. That level took 5 minutes on Wednesday.
Screamer! Man, am I glad to see you!
Screamer!
Hey, Screamer!
Have you got your skateboard?
Yep. And it's my new gnarly all-wheel flex-action titanium radical racer board, too.
Good. We're gonna need it and your awesome moves if we're gonna stop the cheese, dude.
Yeah! Let's go save the beach!
Good, he said, not listening to a single word he said. Alright, so we didn't show off Little Bro last time. He is the protagonist of Yo Bro, and he does appear in this game. And since the game does let you backtrack back to the Woody, I think we'll pick him briefly in Mexico so you can see what Little Bro is all about. Now, were you thinking, okay, there's characters who can kick, punch, fly, jump wide, do an eight-way jump where you spread your legs and everywhere? So what's Little Bro's ability? Well, what sets him apart is that he can't attack.
Cool!
And he realistically pumps his foot on the skateboard, as you would if you were actually riding a skateboard. Which
he
means
looks tired!
Which means if you hold left or right, the speed will constantly fluctuate because the momentum decays realistically. Which is great for a platformer. So this is what he does. You have to go through each level avoiding conflict. I think you can jump on things, but...
Yeah, you fucking screeched that asshole out.
It's really
here.
Not worth it. Yeah, this too.
Oh, I hate that.
Yeah, whenever you turn, it plays a sound louder than everything else in the game. Alright, so you've seen Little Bro.
Bummer.
He says bummer just like his big bro.
Aww.
Fuck you, Little Bro. You're done.
Danny.
We're picking Chicken Man.
Okay. Yeah, Little Bro does have Bobby Hill energy.
Bobby Hill would be more capable than... Whatever, I'm not going to rip on him. Little Bro has had enough people doing that already.
Oh my god.
So this level, you usually have to wind your way around the entire goddamn temple, taking stairways at the end of each ledge.
I remember, it was such a pain in the ass!
Or you can bring in Screamer and just ruin the level completely. Look at that, we're already at the top. Look at his name, Screamer. Now we're gonna take a quick detour over here so we can get a couple of cans that are easy to get.
Screamer!
Screamer!
I'm not gonna get over that! Da 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 da.
Why was there a plosive there? Did he say pay?
Yeah, Screamer loves to watch, Screamer. He loves to watch Screamer videos on Newgrounds.
Yeah.
His favorite. He's just I can't wait until I get yelled at.
He had a real resurgence when Flash was a big thing.
Oh, he loved it.
Everyone was after Screamers. That fucked up his SEO for life, though. Also, this part, just fly up it.
Oh my god.
Fuck everything.
This is a fucking chaos. This is a chaos run.
Yeah, it sure is. Well, I haven't killed the enemies on the side, so they can still pelt me. That's kind of a downside. In this temple, there's 2 1-ups. We'll be getting both of those, because I don't want to leave anything to chance. I'm gonna take this a little slow, because there's so much shit that can hurt you. So has anyone else tried playing this game? I'm curious your thoughts. I have a love-hate relationship with this game. Like, it's not good, but I can't deny that it's charming. It has a weird, odd 90s mascot charm to it.
I love it for being a Beach Boys game that uses fucking Network Music Ensemble music.
Yeah, when they could have just used, you know, Beach Boys music.
You think they didn't have a license to use, like, more Beach Boy songs or something?
Oh, it could be.
Alright.
Another one up down here. Alright, we're up to 8.
Alright!
I gotta say, I Screamer is finally, it's Alex's voice representation.
Mm-hmm.
I am here for it.
Alright. I sound like I'm dying!
Now the other great thing about Screamer is there's a lot of cans just out of reach for every other character in this area. Not for Screamer. He gets extra gas.
You are
so you get It's you get bonuses and it's easier with this character, even though by all accounts the game doesn't want you to use this character yet.
I mean, I understand if they didn't have the license to all the songs, but, like, the characters are for Beach... Like, it's a Beach Boys IP.
Yeah.
The characters are Beach Boys characters from a Beach Boys thing. It's so...
Someone pointed out in the Discord these symbols on the pillars back there.
Oh, they're Led Zeppelin, right?
Yeah, they are the Led Zeppelin symbols that each of the Led Zeppelin band members chose for themselves. And in the mall level, there was, like, a... It was some store called Zofo or Zoso yeah. or something. Now what I want to see is a game with mascot characters featuring the likenesses of Led Zeppelin.
I don't think anyone's brave enough to do that.
I don't think so either. You're all cowards. Oh, if I could get that heart right now, that would be just great. Oh yeah, we're in business.
Yeah, the lives icon, it gets more and more damage the more you get damage. It is one of those things, so that's why he looked like a mummy bear.
Yeah, that was a trend back then. They did it with Cool Spot and several other games. This heart you can't actually get without taking a hit, because that spider is constantly in front of it.
How is that fucking fair?
It's just to tease you.
I like that.
What do you think of the spike that spouts up in front of a freaking can?
I think that...
So you feel extra stupid picking up garbage.
Right. When was Camp California released?
93.
Okay.
It was one of the final Duo games.
Okay, so...
It's Dead Possum Indiana Jones.
Good, good.
Who's hiding the synthesizer.
Oh, that's the holy synthesizer.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus banged out some sick tunes on that thing.
And we made it through Mexico. Now all we gotta do is... Wait a minute. Are we ready to go? Are we in go mode?
Do you have all the instruments?
Yeah. I have all the characters. Fuck, let's do it.
Alright, we're doing it.
Let's jam this Woody to Vegas. Yeah, I do like this game's Disney commentary. There's a lot of anti-Mickey Mouse propaganda,
yeah,
which I agree with.
Mickey is frequently dead.
Now, last time around, I didn't go to the mall before Mexico. That's a mistake. Mm-hmm. If you go to the mall before Mexico, you'll have enough gas to get there and you won't have to eat alive.
What about Coach? Do we need to find Coach?
Coach is in Las Vegas. Couldn't quite make it. My brilliant route has a flaw in it.
Damn.
All right, well, someone else can route out the perfect route for this game. Also, Screamer can get an extra one-up the other characters can't get in this level.
I love Screamer so much, I'm sorry.
Screamer, aka Squeaker.
Oh, he's squeaking. He's Squeaker, all right. Rattnagel!
Yep,
I forgot Rattnagel!
There's the famous
Rattnagel!
There's the famous Rattnagel.
Rattnagel!
And, of course, the Yo Bro reference. Just jamming out with
he's
it here.
He's jamming! We're all jamming with Rattnagel!
I could air guitar to this song.
Oh, me too. Oh, this
even
is
though
the
it's
best.
Saxophone led, but whatever.
This is true art.
So for the other characters, you have to go through this horrible dungeon full of like spikes and shit. But if you go this way with Screamer, I keep calling him Squeaker, you just hit the top level right away. No danger to you at all.
Oh my god.
Screamer, he leads a charmed life. It does have soul to it. That's a good way of putting it.
Yeah.
It's just got that something.
Coach! Val! What are you doing here?
The big cheese captured me when I couldn't pay him off and forced me to sign away the beach.
Like he won't let us go until it's like completely his.
Well, don't worry, because we're putting on a radical gig to raise the money you owe him.
Great. But if we don't get him the money soon, the contract will be legal and he'll foreclose and that power plant will be up and running in no time.
It does sound like Wallace Shawn.
You have to stop him from ruining the environment, Screamer. Look for the elevator to find your way out and onto the roof. Val and I'll sneak out and start setting up for the concert. Good luck!
All right, we got the right dialogue. We are entering the endgame. These are the final levels of Camp California. These levels would be challenging if you didn't have access to the best character who can fly.
Danny, I don't know how to tell you this, but there is no record for Camp California on speedrun.com.
I know, I looked. That's what made me tempted to do a speedrun.
I think we should.
But if I did, I'd have to be the moderator for life. And I don't know if I can accept that responsibility. Yeah, this is typical ICOM level design here at its finest. Just a whole bunch of shit trying to shoot you at once. But if you can fly over it, it's not much of a big deal.
I was... Oh, you want me to shadow manage the page for Danny? No. Please, no.
Hello, this is Danny, the Camp California expert. I'm not here right now. If you'd like to leave a message...
That's a pretty good affix. Very dog-esque. I can't play over them.
I don't know how to get that hard. That's the one mystery remaining in this game to me. Just jamming out under the exhaust vents. Fly to freedom, horrible bird. Or fall to the ground. It's cool. Alright, here's a secret. I don't think this is the worst ICOM game. In fact, I think this might be almost... kinda good? Who disagrees with me? Is it everyone?
I think this is the best ICOM platformer on the system I've seen.
It was their last one. This is the last one they ever made. This came after Death Valley Rally, even.
This game is incredible. Okay, people don't disagree.
You ready for the best cutscene in the game?
Yes, let me turn up the audio here.
Check it out.
Round, round, get around, I get around, yeah, get
Stook.
Around.
That's it.
Why is the moon pulsating? Why is it throbbing? It is...
Because it's made of cheese. That doesn't answer your question. Living cheese.
So is it not piss, but melted cheese?
Oh, maybe that is what it was.
Oh, you sick pervert. You thought it was piss. It was just lovely, molten hot Velveeta.
Liquid gold, they call it. I like these enemies.
Oh god, they're horrible!
Yeah.
Oh, they're nasty little bastards. See, this is why you can't do this at AGDQ, because you know I'm going to have to do commentary, and I'm not going to be able to not call it bastards. I'm going to try so hard!
Look out for the piss, Danny!
I would have to make so many apologies.
Doctors Without Borders just immediately pulls its support.
Doctors Without Borders orders a drone strike on our house.
Look, the money we spend on this drone would usually be spent on sick people, but...
No, it's
We
worth
feel
it.
It's worth it in this case. Alright, in this level, you can get, like, seriously, like 15 enemies on the screen at once, and the game starts to slow down like you wouldn't believe. That actually makes me worry. Like, it slows down to the point where it looks like the game's gonna crash. So let's try to make that not happen.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot about the next part. Alex, the next part is something you haven't seen.
The way that you so enthusiastically told me about this. Also, yeah, this is a Star Wars parody and they're in little fucking...
Yeah, they're stormtroopers. There's one enemy we haven't seen yet, and it's exclusive to the next level. You never see it before or since. Again, rather than since. Gotta be grammatically correct. Damn, 8 lives going into the UFO. Pay!
Oh, I love Screamer. I love Screamer and Squeaker and Asshole and Byron.
Big Asshole, Little Asshole.
Mike Love and all of them. I love them all. Is it Stockholm Syndrome? Is that why I love this game now?
It could be. I mean, we've played it 2 days in a row. And I've played it something like 6 days in a row.
Oh, God. Poor baby.
That's how much you have to play this game to get even decently good at it. But, at the very least, that's the last level. Rather, penultimate level. Here comes your new favorite enemy in the game, Alex. That's right, a mutant rat in a diaper.
What?! Oh my god!
just when you thought this game couldn't surprise you anymore, you're ending up chased through the hamster tubes by giant rats in diapers.
Diaper rats! Diaper, 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 diaper rats!
It's no mistaking that's what it is. It's got a safety pin in it. That's clearly what they're going for. God knows why.
Shout out to all the diaper rats in the world. You are seen and you are valid.
Oh god, it fell on me!
Oh my god!
Did you see that?
Yes!
It fell on me ass first. I gotta get out of here. I got it. Oh god, please, no!
No, no, fall on, no!
Okay, we made it. Hilariously, their engine room is just a couple of hamster wheels. And in here is the final boss.
Is it also a diaper rat?
Wait, that is pre-Earthworm Jim, isn't it?
Yeah.
Earthworm Jim did something very similar. No diapers involved, thankfully, but... Yeah, you fought, you rode on giant hamsters in one of the levels. And it was in tubes, just like that.
Hey.
So what does this map represent, you think?
All the churches in America. Little crosses.
Beach Boy sales by region.
I like that there's Yo Bro in the back. I think that's very nice.
Mm-hmm. Now this boss has five phases. We're on phase three. You can literally just stand here and throw your boomerang at him. You'll take a lot of hits from these homing missiles, but it's hard to dodge them anyways. And we got lives to burn.
Oh yeah, and to reiterate, the game is not actually called Camp California the Revenge. We are just getting revenge on Camp California.
Yeah. Okay, I think this is the final form. I think he has different attacks with each form, but I've never really let him do that. Oh, he's doing the Dr. Robotnik thing.
Oh, fuck him.
Is this it? I think that's it. He's toast.
Is that the big cheese?
That was the big cheese.
Did you win?
Uh-huh. And look who it was all along.
Oh, it's Plato's cave, baby.
Mm-hmm. But...
Plato's rat!
That's not the end. Because they go the Metroid route. We gotta escape. The time bomb has been set. Gotta get the hell off the moon.
Oh, shit.
While this extremely peaceful music plays in the background.
Oh, this kicks ass!
Alright, we're almost done. Get ready on time.
Okay,
And time.
Who landed on you?
Brother Bear.
Oh, thank you, Brother Bear.
Byron the Bear.
Byron. Thank you, Comic Chameleon, for the 8-month sub. They say you did it.
Thank you. Thank you all for the you did it's, and yeah, that was a one credit clear. Pretty happy about that.
Is this a concert?
Mm-hmm. There he is.
I love him. 25 bits from Orange Wright saying you did it. Thank you.
Thank you.
There he is. There's Screamer.
Mm-hmm.
It's totally excellent that we had enough money left over from the gig we put on to buy a bodacious boombox for the clubhouse.
That's right, little asshole.
Yeah, nothing like tunage on a hot summer day. Hey, where's Pouch hanging out today?
I saw him head for the water a while ago. I think he said something about getting away from it all.
Ah, now this is the line. A cool drink and a cooler posterior. Set adrift on a sea of tranquility. What?
Oh.
Heads up, Pouch! How can you lie around on such an awesome day? Like, we win the beach back and all you can do is loaf? Why would you want to do that?
Because we can!
Wink. Thank you for the 100 bits going towards our new boombox.
It's gonna be bodacious.
Free on Leon, much appreciated.
Thank you.
And here we have a list of all the people you can blame for this game.
Thank you all. Whoever designed the fucking Screamer Birds, you are Word.
You're the best. Thanks to Nuts in Minneapolis.
You are beautiful no matter what they say.
This was a good one. I enjoyed this game.
Amazing.
Probably not in a conventional sense for most of it, but yeah, it just has its own charm. I can't deny that.
That was perfect.
It lives by the philosophy that kids of all ages should let kids be kids. And then it resets. It just straight up says, no, you're absolutely done with this game. Reset into the BIOS now.
Thank you to Labos for gifting a sub to Freon Leon, and thank you also to Labos for resubbing. I think I saw that there. Thank you.
Nice, thank you.
For one credit. Thank you. Appreciated.
Yeah. All right, now that's a one credit clear I can hang on my hat rack. I feel good about that one.
That was really good.
Thank you.
I'm proud of you, husband.
That was an informative and somewhat skilled playthrough of Camp California. Feel free to use that route if you plan to speedrun it, and if you do speedrun it, let me know, because I want to be your competition. Not quite sure if I want to be the speedrun guy just yet. I'll have to think about that.
Yeah,
for
someone
a while.
Else do it so Danny can beat you or whatever.
All right, so next up, a little bit of a change of schedule. We're going to do Shapeshifter first.
Ooh. That's also ICOM, yeah?
Yep, we're going from ICOM to ICOM.
The ICOM pals.
This one came out slightly before Camp California, like a few months before. I believe it's post-Death Valley Rally, pre-Camp California. We played this before.
Have we?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I think we streamed it briefly. And guess who gets to play it?
Oh, goddamn, I forgot. I forgot if I have to play games on Friday.
I will let you know, first of all, this game has probably my least favorite Turbo CD soundtrack. Some of these tracks are just... ugh. They're awful on the ears. On the other hand, this is a game where you're a barbarian,
mm-hmm.
and you can transform into cool critters, like a panther, some other stuff. Mostly I just remember the panther.
Prosperity, the ancient prophets once said, is the wellspring of our dreams. Surely this was true in the land of Krellion. And with this prosperity, a new age was ushered into the world.
Yeah, man, check it
an
out.
Age of many names.
Wizard shit!
The dwarves chatted in their mountain halls, while woodland elves sang the song of Dave Kathlatana.
John B. Marine, pretty much.
Simply called it
this is Altered Beast.
Age of Light.
Or as Ray called it earlier on Twitter, Alternate Beast.
Now, behind this prosperity lied its source, a fellowship of powerful wizards, five in all, called the Ring of Five. The Ring was the heartbeat of Krellion, and like a river brings life to a dry land,
you might call
so
it a fellowship
did the
of
Ring
a
of Five bring life to its people.
Uh-huh.
Now loading.
But on the fifth moon of the Age of Light, the river turned black. The prophecies foretold such an event, but few would ever believe it. And as the people cried out to the Great Mother, a dark wave of evil began to sweep across the land, leaving a wide path of destruction in its wake.
Oh, Great Mother, save us from these skeletons that have to be in every ICOM game.
Every fucking game.
And the Ring of Five, which had protected Krellion for centuries untold, suddenly vanished from the land, their fate lying in the unholy hands of three evil beings from the Shadow Realm. Three beings of unthinkable power, known as the Dark Ones.
Yeah, skeleton in the intro is a pretty quick time to skeleton. That's like 0 seconds, technically.
Yeah, this is also a really good use of dithering. Like, it actually is kind of effective.
Now
yeah.
The midsummer equinox is almost at hand, and with this event, the Dark Ones will shatter the barrier that lies between Krellion and the Shadow Realm. But there is a single light in the darkness. His name is Lycos, and he has the power to save Krellion before it's too late, and the land is plunged into a dark, eternal nightmare. Never to awaken.
Never to awaken.
I forgot his name was Lycos.
Lycos!
Oh, we're going to make a lot of jokes we've made before.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Shapeshifter. A barbarian platformer for Turbo Super CD.
This! I remember this!
Yeah, you remember this. You remember this.
Yes, I remember!
The Windows,
I need a minute!
The Windows notification sound is not an instrument. Do not use it like one. Alright, so to progress in this game, first you gotta go to the top floor of this village.
By order of Grarlin, Chancellor of Trehelm, none may pass.
But I must leave the city, Sir Knight.
I have specific orders from the Chancellor. The city shall remain sealed.
Yeah, head back to that elevator, go to the top floor, and then head to the left. There's something you have to get. Oh god. Barbarian Action News! Yeah, there you go. Seriously, I fucking hate the music in this game.
If it isn't a barbarian, lad. Now, what is it I can do for you? I'm a very busy man these days.
I'd like to leave your town, but I can see that the gates are locked. What is going on?
Well, you haven't heard. The spider folk to the west have gone half mad. The Mariders usually mind their own business, but it is their spawning season and they have stolen people from their very homes.
Will no one go and challenge these Mariders?
The people in this town are simple folk, and they fear for their lives.
Then let me go. You need only grant me a weapon and an open gate, and I will hunt down these Mariders and return your people.
I have no choice but to accept your offer, lad. Here is some gold and a scroll that will open the west gate. See the smithy and buy a weapon. If you return, you will be rewarded. Godspeed, lad!
Godspeed.
Those do look like croissants, absolutely.
Oh yeah, he's wearing those big-ass croissants.
I was gonna say, also, Electric Boogaloo points out that it shares much of the same voice cast as, Hold on.
You could make an effort to go into a door before the worst part of the song plays, but you're gonna let it play every time.
Yes,
Hey, it's Tiny Head Tim.
Come in, sit down, and let me foreshadow the things that are to come!
I'm leaving.
Is this Squeaker?
No, I'm out.
Tweaker?
I'm
Squawker?
Out.
What was his name?
Screamer.
Okay.
But, yeah, this did feature a lot of the same overlapping Minneapolis voice cast as Camp California. Also, we missed thanking Simon for their 3 subs, so thank you for that.
Oh, nice, thank you.
Good day, barbarian! How can I help thee?
I have come to buy a weapon.
Of course! Please look around my shop!
Alright, you need to get yourself an axe. Because you are a barbarian, after all.
I click purchase?
Yeah. Get that axe.
I will take this battle axe. Here is your gold.
A fine choice. May it serve you well.
We can't show this, so I must say it. I am going to take the battle axe and give you the gold.
Okay, can I head out now?
Yeah. Yeah, head out to the left and... Thank you. Alex doing me a favor for once.
I have a decree from Grarlin, Chancellor of Trehelm.
Aye. It is his seal. You may pass, warrior.
Yep, this is a Castlevania 2-like, including the day-night cycle. And when night falls, something happens. I forgot.
They explode! So, okay, I just want to say those trees look like chunky shit. That's some Minecraft trees.
They do look like chunky shit. Oh, it's nighttime. That's right, whenever it's nighttime, your health gets restored. So that's a mechanic that's kind of unusual. Right off, you can see the influences, of course, Shadow of the Beast. This game wants to be Shadow of the Beast so bad. And it succeeds in some ways. I will say it gives you a lot of health, but also it just bombards you constantly. So, it's an ICOM game. I love the enemies that get on top of your hitbox and then don't leave. there are good things about this game. The voice acting's pretty funny. And this song, listen to this.
You can dance if you want to.
Wait, it rips off another song, actually.
Barbarian, leave me alone.
Oh, it's all coming back to me.
Okay, I can't go in those houses, right?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I tried, and it's like absolutely not.
Now, people mentioned during the intro this had some pretty good use of dithering for the cutscenes, and yeah, the TurboGrafx hardware could do some decently colorful stuff. Even gameplay is pretty colorful. And ICOM in particular, especially with their later game, Beyond Shadowgate, that had a lot of good cutscene graphics.
Also, apparently this game has a vocal track.
It does. I think it's the ending track.
Oh no, there's people caught in the spider's web.
You gotta save them. Beginning, you may be questioning, is this really a platformer, because all you're doing is running to the left, but there is platforming in this game.
What? I got an orb.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
It's the orb of music stoppage.
I thought it was going to load a cutscene or something.
No.
It stopped.
Oh yeah, you got a power up now. It is a damn good thing it gives you so many lives and gives you so many hits before you die. The game kind of reminds me of the Addams Family in that respect, another ICOM platformer for Turbo CD.
Could you not, guys?
Maybe the whole bombarding the player with enemies is an actual good design choice. Does anyone feel that way? Does anyone think Mario 1 would be better if there were just like 20 Goombas on the screen at once, all inside your hitbox?
Making this easier.
Those boys at ICOM. Oh yeah, look at that! Look at you! You got him trapped in a pattern.
She's in it.
If Mario Maker taught me anything, yes. Okay, so the spirit of ICOM lives on in Mario Maker.
Do I just go back now?
Jump around the screen and see if it makes anything happen, but otherwise, yeah, I think you just head back. Yeah, it looks like you just head back. You may be able to free the people now.
Not a bad idea. Thanks for watching. No, don't go back!
Yeah, see you around.
No! No, I'm out. No.
Apparently, this game established some expectations with the initial cutscenes. And yeah, the actual game does kind of betray how the cutscenes looked.
Stop that!
We'll say, not the worst art I've seen in an ICOM game. Some of their stuff looks pretty amateurish.
Stop running them.
Good lord, that's seriously like 10 enemies right as you entered the screen.
Okay, I don't like having the projectile right now. It actually kind of sucks. It's good for the boss, but...
Yeah. Actually, let me read a fact, just to make sure we don't get lost.
Well, you're taking a...
You gotta reach the, They recommend carefully avoiding that first power-up because it makes this part harder.
Sure does!
Okay, you gotta go back to town and speak to the Chancellor.
Was that that guy who was just like, I'll give you this thing, or
I think
whatever.
It was that guy with the tiny head.
Oh, tiny head.
do it.
I didn't do it intentionally. I'm not doing it intentionally.
The soundtrack is a mixture of Tom Petty and Europe and Windows notification sounds.
By the Great Mother, you have returned. I knew your quest was a success when my guards found the forest swept clean of spiders and were able to free my captured people. I am forever in your debt. Here, please take this bag of gold and accept my eternal thanks.
Thank you, my lord, for your gracious words and your gift. Fare thee well.
Aye, fare thee well.
Ooh, the Undertaker!
I just want to eat those tasty, tasty rolls on his shoulders.
Me too.
So delicious.
I would much rather play Altered Beast, but that's just me.
All right, time to find the Chancellor. I'll go as fast as I can.
We're here to rank this game fairly. Give it a fair trial.
Ah, warrior, you have returned! I can see in your eyes that it is a prophecy or two that you seek.
All right, why don't you go save? And after this, it's on the top row of the town.
I think I shall take a pass today, probably.
Yeah, the save is that one guy.
Your future is of no interest then, so be it. Good day, warrior.
I love his voice, I just want to say.
And what you've done is you've unlocked the right gate out of town, so you can do that after you save.
Okay. Sorry, the elevator's too slow. Oh, every fucking time.
Hector, yeah, we have played this before, but not on Mascot Friday. We gotta get this game judged.
Saving.
Good. Don't want to do that first part again. Alright.
So I can just leave?
Mm-hmm. Now you gotta go continue your quest. Do you want me to play?
Let me just see how this is. Mm.
Nice. Good work, Alex.
Here you go.
Oh, handing over the controller in shame. Okay, so what that was is...
Am I not supposed to do that?
These dudes on crutches are beggars, and if they touch you, they will drain your money, so you do have to kill them.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Yeah, see? He took a gold from me.
Danny!
Real good mechanics in this game is what I'm saying. Oh, cool.
About time you got here, young Lycos.
How did you know my name, old woman?
Why do you ask why? Is it not enough that you take your own sweet time with the Mariders while you leave a poor defenseless woman sitting alone in the forest?
Wait a minute, how did you...
Enough of your...
Sorry, I had something to do.
Soon you'll be asking me why Krellion has three moons. My time here is short, so keep quiet and listen to me. It will not be long before the Dark Ones enter this world. The equinox is almost at hand. All will be lost if you, Lycos, do not find the Ring of Five.
What is the Ring of Five?
Are you totally unlearned? The Ring of Five is order where there is chaos. It is light where there is darkness. The Ring is a powerful group of wizards that have kept the heart of this world alive. That is, until now. The Dark Ones, three powerful evil brothers from the Shadow Realm, have imprisoned the Ring of Five somewhere in the land.
I'm just watching the timer up there. We've been talking all night.
I can't possibly do it alone, old woman. I think that you are not as helpless as you seem. Can you help me find them?
No, I cannot.
Nay.
I am forbidden, but I can do this. In this world, there are many illusions, but now you shall see through them. Beware, Lycos. You are like a young lion. You possess the will, but lack the power that commands it. You cannot stop the Dark Ones until you become what you are not.
Okay, so we gotta become what we are not. And what we are not is in this cave. Now, the boss here, once we beat him, we'll get the first transformation, and we'll get some very important information about how you should rank this game. Wow, this controls like shit. I forgot. And man, the game has never looked more like Shadow of the Beast than it does now.
I do like that you were able to transform in front of her mid-speech.
Yeah, that was cool. And she didn't even acknowledge it.
She was too busy cooking her hot dog.
Warrior, do you know the joys of camping? Are you completely unlearned? I bet you don't even know what glamping is.
You keep making glamping jokes. I'm going to take you glamping one day.
Don't you dare.
Oh, I'm going to dare.
Look at that thing. It's just a pile of guts. What even is that?
I'm going to fill your canteen with Avion and LaCroix.
Oh my God. Don't even.
I
refuse to glamp.
I'm going to get a $2,000 a month studio tent.
Mm-hmm. All right, coming up in 3, 2, 1, the best joke of the night. Glamp California. Thank you.
Oh, I love you, but that's awful.
The controls in this game are very stiff, which is not unusual for an ICOM game. But after you get the transformations, they become actively worse, as you'll see in a second.
Glamp in peace, John. I'm going to be thinking about Glamp California for a while.
Good. Some of the art in this game is pretty good. It's just really uneven. Oh, by the way, these 9 lives, or 10 lives rather, you get them by, Do I have to repeat the boss? Okay. You only get 10 lives for the game. Once those are gone, the game's over. No continues. Even Glamp California did you better than that. See, before the show, you were talking about Clamp California, which was a different thing. Got him.
Nice.
Oh, they got some guitar in here.
I knew that you would come, young one. Even with my powers bound by the Dark Ones, I could sense your power and your will.
Clamp Rock.
My name is Gerolyn the White.
I am Lycos, and I have vowed to find the Ring of Five and stop the evil that will blasphemy this world.
I cannot sense the others. Have they been freed?
Nay, Sir Gerolyn, you are the first.
Then you must move quickly, my son.
Oh my God.
I see a power in you that must be freed. Tar Kalak at Katar Angador. Now go, and may the Great Mother guide your path.
You are now greater than your predecessor, Jeeves. I give you the name Ask Jeeves. Alright, so what he gave us is the power to transform into a panther, which we need to climb out of this goddamn cave. And you'll see why that's a problem in just a second. Can I do it now? Yep, I sure can. I can be Panther Man.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Wow.
So the panther's pretty cool. Got some nice animations. He can jump. He really commits to his jumps. You cannot change his direction in midair, unlike the barbarian. And the absolute worst part of the panther is whenever you go to the edge of any ledge, it automatically leaps down. And that's a real problem, because ICOM games don't give you much room at the edge of a platform, so you'll be constantly falling off shit as the panther.
Oh, I just saw you fall. Oh my...
It did that all automatically. Okay, so as an exercise for the viewer, Alex, here you go.
Try climbing
up out of this cave.
Okay.
This is to prove that both this game is a platformer, and boy, does it ever have some problems.
Wow!
See that?
Wow!
Yeah, if you land on the edge of a platform, it'll automatically jump off. So you have to specifically avoid the edges and, like, just aim for the center, the dead center of every platform.
Stop puking on me!
Like rapid fire puke.
Okay, I got it this time, and then I'm gonna hand it back to you. Stop that.
People are getting mad just looking at this in action. You don't even know unless you've played it. Just watching a panther go out of your control and jump down 5 platforms in a row is the worst.
No!
Watch when you turn around.
I can't. I know I'll die. No. Okay, this.
It's like learning another language.
Oh, I changed back?
No, you're good. Thought you landed too near the edge. Oh, you landed?
No! Danny, take the controller before I scream.
Oh my god. Alex is not a fan.
Yeah, okay, I can see McCoff freaking out, because this
It is easily the worst part of the game. The rest of the game can be tolerable. This is just shit. Like, I can't even spin this in a good way.
Do you need to be the panther here?
You absolutely need to be the panther.
Oh, bull!
And best of all, there's later parts where you have to be the panther.
Stay away from that ledge. Do not try it that way.
And it's all above bottomless pits, so that's how you lose all your lives in this game. Okay, we have to very carefully land this thing. There we go.
Good.
Just always be in the middle of each platform.
Thank you.
Nope.
No!
Again.
No!
Okay, I did two jumps on my own. The rest was automatic.
This is Pocus beyond belief. I am mad.
I'm glad we got to show this off, because this is a very unique problem for a platformer to have. I can't think of any other platformer where this is the case. It jumped backwards into the spikes. I love that.
I'm pissed. I'm actually...
So in a way, this game's innovative. This is frustrating in a way like no other game is, and I kind of admire it for that, but also, it's horrible. If you really want to piss off your friends, though, have a save state saved right after you get the panther, and then challenge them to get out of this godforsaken cave.
I'm trying to get up one ledge!
It's pretty good.
Just getting up to one more level, God! The platformer that fucked up the platforming so bad!
So what do you think of Camp California now?
I love Camp California. It's a masterpiece of form and function. What do they call that? Ludonarrative cognitive dissonance? I don't fucking know. Anyways, it's perfect.
Hey, I made it. I'm really curious to see where this game's gonna end up on the list, because this is a really obvious problem. And... I may move on to Tailspin in just a sec. I pushed the jump button once, and I did like 50 flips.
This sucks!
But yeah, I encourage you to play this. It is uniquely frustrating.
Bad! I'm sorry.
It is just bad.
Oh, someone died in the production of this game? Okay.
Oh my god. Rest in peace.
Oh, that's... No!
On the plus side, I only have one life left, so you may get to see the game over screen soon.
No!
That backwards jump!
I'm so mad!
And even when you're not jumping, you're just being swarmed by shit.
God, you're getting migrated by those bees! God, don't! This is usually I don't freak out when the game is treating you like this, but this is just astonishingly bad. This is literally the worst thing you could do in a platformer is make someone automatically jump off the platform.
No idea why they did it that way. It makes no sense.
Just.
Oh yeah, it just jumps all over the place like a dumbass, like a panther.
Damn, the found. Okay, I think I did see that earlier in the chat, but it kind of flew by. Todd Zipnick, the founder of ICOM, died.
Oh, that's right, they did lose their founder around this time. Man, ICOM just had real bad luck at this point.
Yeah, okay, yeah, that's the people who do the vocal track for this game are called the Zipnick Youth, and what? Okay, hold on.
And this, my friend, is how the hope of Krellion died. And every last one of us, man, woman, and child alike, became slaves of the Dark Ones.
Every one of us.
Some say hope never truly dies.
and perhaps a new hero will someday rise among us. We can only pray that their words will one day prove true.
A hero who doesn't slip off of platforms. Maybe someday, but until then, literally everyone on Earth is enslaved. Good work. Shapeshifter, a controversial title for the TurboGrafx-16 CD-ROM.
Oh, it's very controversial. Oh, I'm very controverted. Oh.
Now, compared to that, now, you have opinions and feelings about what you just saw.
Yes, I am pissed. I am furious. I am...
And what better way to follow that up than with another Disney game by the people who made Darkwing Duck? This is Tailspin.
I don't like this.
Are we ready for this?
No! No!
Is this game going to be better than Darkwing Duck?
You tried so hard to play this game,
Yeah, I mentioned at the top of the show, if you have a Turbo EverDrive, that's what it's called, at least the earlier ones, if you use the correct ROM dump of Tailspin, it won't play. You need to use a hacked ROM. It's called, for reference, this one. You can show the screen.
Okay.
Tailspin UH1, that's the one that works on flash carts.
Thank you to Hachiko Syndrome for the raid, ooh, and for the 14-month sub. Do appreciate that.
14 months, thank you.
Yeah.
And welcome, everyone. We're about to play Tailspin, another game from the makers of Darkwing Duck, which is currently our lowest-rated platformer on Mascot Friday.
It's gotta be good.
Looking forward to this. Hey, Alex, you want to play a game?
No.
There you go.
No. Danny. Okay, it loads.
Let me untangle this.
Oh, it's tangled.
Yeah, last time this was voted in, the ROM just didn't load. This time it works. Look at him. There he is.
Okay. Baloo the bear. I like that art. I like the music. Tailspin. Okay. Okay, right, I'll listen to Louie.
So Louie's here. It's the key to your dreams. You gotta find this map or something. This could go any number of ways. You know how badly Darkwing Duck went.
Uh-huh. We're gonna... Cool. Love a bunch of gold.
Simple. Oh, if only this game was on CD. Could have voices.
Alright.
Could have a panther character who automatically jumps off of ledges. And this game actually lets you choose your first level.
Shere Khan. Ice caves, no thank you. You're gonna get wet going for this piece. Alright, we're gonna go to the Watusi River Valley.
Yeah, I also watched this a lot as a kid, but I don't remember anything about it. It was on before school, so I was, like, barely even awake when I watched this.
I didn't watch it because I thought it was kind of boring. Sorry if this show wasn't boring, but I was more of a DuckTales kid.
Later they replaced it with Goof Troop, which I thought was way better. Anyway, we got a game here. It's got some parallax scrolling. It's got another bear that you control, linking it to tonight's first game.
One hit deaths, good.
Oh, you get multiple hits, it's just that was a bottomless pit.
So it starts off from a bottomless pit, that's cool.
Uh-huh. Gotta throw you in the deep end.
Oh my god.
Now, the graphics in this game are kind of strange. I mean, Baloo looks good, but it's just kind of dark. Kind of pallid, you know? Not what you'd expect from a Disney cartoon.
Well, so far I can get further in it than I can with Darkwing Duck.
Mm-hmm.
So that's something. Oh, stop that!
How are the controls compared to the Panther and Shapeshifter?
They are better. Are you kidding?
Smebble says this looks like a bad Amiga game. Doesn't it, though? It really does have that Amiga look to it. Alex tried to go away. Yeah, this is by Radiant Software, who did Darkwing Duck, as well as the unreleased California Raisins game for NES.
Oh, that was...
And this game actually plays a little bit similar to California Raisins. In that you jump around and you throw stuff at things. That's about where the similarities end, I suppose. Yeah, Capcom decided a game by Radiance was not worth releasing. Over on TurboGrafx there, though, they had lower standards. Oh, you can throw up.
I sure can! Have you seen the graphics here? That was bad, I'm sorry.
That background there That was an enemy?
Yeah!
Alright.
Fine, I'll continue.
That's true. California Raisins did give us congratu-raisins, so I can't stay too mad at it. Now, for the record, I thought California Raisins was better than Darkwing Duck. I don't know about this one, though. I haven't played enough of this to decide. I'm gonna change that tonight.
I wish you luck, Bambi. This game kinda sucks.
Yeah, it's hard to go from Shapeshifter to this in terms of graphics. Shapeshifter had some pretty detailed backgrounds compared to this. But you should keep your expectations in check. This is a pretty early Turbo Chip game, not a Super CD-ROM masterpiece. Oh, you can't duck and throw.
Why am I even attacking these people? They don't want me to take their gold, and I don't fucking blame them! Come on, Galoo. Is that it?
Can you drop down here?
I'm so afraid.
Okay, good. Okay. Alright, well, you skipped the frustrating route through the level by taking the difficult route, so good job there.
Good.
Usually you'd fight a river which takes you back every time you fall in it, and it's easy to fall in.
Join his drum! Why do I have to fucking kill? Whatever.
Skills. Huh? Hey, you got to the first boss. It's further than most people get.
Look
in
at
this
the
game.
Momentum of the fucking coconut when it hits him.
I kind of like that. I like that they programmed in the coconut just kind of slamming into something and then sliding off. I think that's neat. Joker's trick.
That was a Joker's trick, I'm mad. You have to throw so many fucking coconuts. Yeah, Blue's a colonizer, unfortunately. Blue, don't.
I thought he was an air pirate, or like some kind of delivery guy.
He is, but I guess also now he's just, you know. Blue, your violence is unnecessary.
Music sounds familiar. It may be from the show, but I don't know. They could have stolen it from somewhere else. Alright, so this guy has two attacks. He jumps low and he jumps high. Once you know that, you may be able to beat him.
Me? Beat it?
You could do it.
Okay. Well, you have to play once I'm done, so I don't know if you want to encourage me.
No, I don't want to. Yeah, this doesn't look fun. But I guess I have to.
So Baloo's a smuggler, so is his work legal or illegal?
I think he operates above the law. I think he has diplomatic immunity.
Because he's Baloo?
Yeah. All the characters from the Jungle Book, they got diplomatic immunity.
That tracks.
Yeah, let's explore that while we're here. How did it get to Tailspin? Like, Jungle Book, as far as I knew, they were just like jungle animals, and now they're like smugglers. Did they ever explain how that came to be? They might have.
Hate it!
You did it.
Oh my god. Well, it's your turn now.
King Gamer Alex.
Why am I playing? Oh my god, I actually did do it.
You sure did.
What the hell? Unfortunately, you did miss Camp California, known as Clamp California, known as Culp California, known as Blamp California.
We'll have an archive up. Mm-hmm. They didn't mute the VOD last time, so it should be fine. Alright, so there's bonus levels where you control Skip, and you got a Sky Surf. And the controls in this are real weird. Look at this. You're actually just controlling the plane. And Skip just kind of does, you know, whatever. Eventually you get the hang of it, though, kinda. You just makes me wonder, is there any part of the game that controls normally? Can this just be a normal game?
Blue is a Sovereign Nation guy, take that back!
Oh, I missed the one-up.
Blue is a norm- is... I guess I can't say blue is normal. Blue is not normal.
Is his name Skip? Am I just saying
it's Skip, yes. Okay. I'm pretty sure it's Kit. Oh, it's Kit. Sorry, I'm remembering furrydom from back in the day, and yeah, it's Kit.
Where's this guy? He wants us to find propellers.
Kit Cloud... Is it Skipper or Kicker?
It's Cloud Chaser.
So Kit also vapes.
He's always after those big clouds.
I gotta say, I'm sorry for being this way, but those mechanic guys who are trying to kill you?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty cute.
Yeah. They're in uniform.
It's Cloud Kicker. Okay.
Kit Cloud Kicker.
Hey, Danny.
Uh-huh.
Do you think Blue is also a Big Bear Daddy like Byron?
Well, we don't have a theme song to confirm that, but... I mean, just look at him.
Okay, so this is a split continuity from the Jungle Book.
Oh, is that what it is? Okay. There isn't, like... They're not, like, related.
I wish it was. I wish it was just like, oh, we left India and decided to go to South America to do a bunch of air piracy.
Yeah, seemed fun. Seemed like the market was there.
Yeah, after Mowgli went back to live with man, he was like, dude, have you heard of airplanes? They kick ass. And we were like, wow.
Meanwhile, Mowgli went on to star in the hit film Jungle to Jungle.
Oh my god, Kit Cloud Kicker is in the new DuckTales? Oh,
he is? Wow. They got the Gizmo Duck. They got Darkwing in there, too. I gotta watch more of that. That show is pretty darn good.
Kit looks like Baloo! That's Bubba Duck! I'm pissed!
They brought back Bubba Duck? Alright.
Bubba Duck, and also the Wuzzles are there. Remember the fucking Wuzzles?
No. I don't.
Of course you don't. No one remembers the goddamn Wuzzles. The Wuzzles are like the... Like, everyone talks about the Fluffy Dogs, but who remembers the Wuzzles?
Everybody talks about the Fluffy Dogs?
They sure do. I'm always seeing tweets about Fluffy Dogs on my timeline, but never about the Wuzzles.
I guess I don't follow the right people.
Well, you need to follow the Fluffy community.
Okay, if you continue, it leaves you off at the last checkpoint. That's nice. If it made you start the level over, I'd be mad. Because these levels are not... I don't want to make any judgments. Let's be nice to these video games, because they deserve it, I guess.
Don't. This fucking sucks. Yeah, also the new DuckTales is quite good. I recommend it. It's
yeah,
good.
Check it out.
Snubbles mentions that you're literally here to judge them.
Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot what I was doing here. You know, this is not an ICOM game, but considering the amount of shit constantly pelting you, you'd be easily confused.
This sucks.
Hmm. Also remember, this is not Darkwing Duck.
Okay, I'm just gonna say it. I don't know how I feel about Goofy being in the DuckTales universe. Because if Goofy is in it, you know what that means. That means Mickey's in this universe.
Oh, fuck that. It
scares the shit out of me.
Mickey's got enough money. Stay away from Scrooge.
He's gonna ask Scrooge to invest in his new venture capital project. Good. If Mickey gets into DuckTales, I'm sorry. I'm gonna be one of those annoying guys online who like makes petitions for people to change their favorite shows.
Better start loading up change.org.
Oh, it's Goof Troop Go Goofy? Is it okay?
Is that canonically a different Goofy?
I'm seeing people saying it's Goof Troop Goofy. It's not Goof Troop Goofy. I do not know the Goofy canon we're using. Yeah, Disney is weirdly controlling of Mickey. Mickey is extremely tightly controlled. He is basically kept in a hyperbolic chamber until needed.
It feels like I've been playing this segment forever.
You have.
You know what? Throw in a couple more guys throwing boxes.
Why not?
I didn't get it yet. Alright, good. I hope there's more guys throwing boxes up here.
Okay, I have to find which Goofy it is. It does. I will say, where's that Goofy? Let me find Goofy. Like, that is Goof Troop Goofy. Oh god. Oh god, he's back. Oh,
killer ceiling fans. That's not something I've seen in a game.
Oh hey, they're trying to kill you too.
That's unique. And they seem to have no pattern. That's nice.
Goof Troop Goofy is the Goofy who has sex. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that is true. Confirmed.
I hate that. If you want to know about the buff horse with Scrooge's face, watch the show. Disney, pay me for this promotion, by the way.
Got the money. Give it to us.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're busting in the office. Who are we going to fight?
Bye, Cactus B. Avoid Shere Khan. I like that when he bangs on his desk, things fall off. That rules.
That's neat. Hey, I did it.
The bear with butterfly wings, I think, is supposed to be one of the Wuzzles, but, like, scary.
Talking about the Wuzzles like they're a real thing.
They are a real thing! Little Britches. Don't like that nickname. Hey, Kate, could you pick up some points for me?
Can you do it in, like, the most dangerous way possible? I also like that the point awards in this game are just points.
Yeah!
They didn't even have enough imagination to make them, like, fruit or something. Or, you know, cargo.
Oil cans.
Right, we didn't work at Radiant Software. They've probably been through a whole bunch of shit.
This is largely by the same team as Darkwing Duck and Green Dog.
Jesus Christ, I didn't know Green Dog had a connection here. Alright, the C is a continue. That's pretty good. Oh, I did not know there was a Green Dog link. Believe it or not, we're halfway through this game.
Are you gonna keep playing until you die?
I really don't want to play more of this.
Well, it is close to judgment time, so. Oh my god. Stop doing that! It's disgusting!
Squirt, squirt.
Stop
squirt,
it!
Squirt.
I know it's Friday, but you have to have some self-control. So how does this part control?
Well, he kind of skids around a lot now. So that's cool.
Did you get... Oh, you died, and now you're back to life, Danny. You've got 3 lives left. Danny, please.
No one can see me squirting if I do it under the sea.
Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ.
I've played this part before. It's bad.
Sure, it looks like it.
Because there's no challenge. You just squirt. No jumping, no avoiding. Like, if things get past your squirts, they're gonna hit you.
I think Shere Khan is a corrupt businessman, not a politician. But if he is a politician, that would kind of rule. I would love to see an evil politician get owned by a big fat bear.
Gah.
Don't clip that.
Gah. Oh, it's so easy to get hit in this part.
He's an evil banker? Okay, that's beautiful.
There's almost no invincibility time in this game, too, have you noticed? It's so easy to get generated by everything.
Mm-hmm. I hate the way that you can squirt, like, straight up. Please. Please.
Well, you know what they say. Life is much better down where it's wetter. Agreed.
Sure, why not? Why fuck not?
Okay, I think I got this now. You always want to squirt diagonally. Squirting to the side does nothing.
Am I okay? I am not. Okay.
I'm not looking at the chat. Are they learning a lot?
Well, Shere Khan owns the Khan Concern, supermarkets, coal-fired power stations, banks, and gas stations, whose net worth is quoted to be worth $3.7 billion. I thank you for that, Shere Khan.
Damn, Lord. He's a billionaire.
Not just that, he owns a bunch of fossil fuel shit, so he's, super evil. He is absolutely gonna... That, Shere Khan, you are not gonna survive the next century. You are...
Oh, we're hauling some guillotines today, buddy.
I was gonna say, you want Danny to stop saying squirt? We should make that like a donation incentive. Are you on your last? Okay, you're on your last. You're on your last credit here.
I did hit a checkpoint, though. That's okay. Good. This is the furthest I've been in this level. I don't think the crabs can be killed. On the other hand, with the right timing, I can jump over this stuff.
I have been sent a gif. I'm afraid to click it.
Wow. God! All right. Yeah, live footage of Baloo right now.
Oh, so it was. Oh, okay. So basically, Shere Khan ran a company town, and oh man, I gotta watch Tailspin. This is
sounds like it's up your alley.
I was gonna say I always found it boring, but maybe I'd like the political worker intrigue. No. Oh, don't mention Squart, please. Why don't you get an extra?
I see what you're doing here, Tailspin. You're just here to piss me off.
This game is bad.
Well, you can't piss me off. I had a great day. You ain't gonna do shit to me.
That's right, nothing can piss us off.
I one credit cleared Camp California. Mm-hmm. You're not gonna take that away from me. Unless it somehow deletes the VOD.
Well, we have a local copy.
Alright, good. A lot of different fish you can squirt down here. What's this icon? Invincibility?
Oh, thank God.
It lasts for like 5 seconds. Look at him strut. Underwater strut. Ah, I see. He dives at you.
Alright, good luck, Danny.
Let's beat this guy.
We're all rooting for you. We're all supporting you. That move.
You can squirt in so many directions, though.
Okay.
It gives you so many more combat options. Hey! Got him!
Holy shit. You did it!
I'm weirdly close to beating the game, and I know that's not gonna happen, because after you beat the first four levels, there's a fifth level.
Well, try it, because you've got very little life left, so you
okay.
Know.
Let's go ahead and try out that fourth level, and then I think we'll get to judging. Now, I wanted to slip in a final game, Adam's Family, but I think we'll save that for another time. That's another ICOM classic, and after tonight, that'll be the only ICOM platformer we have not ranked. I have kind of trouble calling that a platformer, though, considering so much of that game is just flat. You don't jump on many platforms. Oh, got to continue.
Nice.
I could play this all night, theoretically.
You really could. You want to go overtime, I'm not going to stop you.
To play this? Danger Woman requires 7 ice bars.
God, you have to help Danger Woman!
It's an ice level. It's a fucking ice level.
Oh, those must be the Russian boars that someone in chat mentioned.
Yeah. Game's got all your favorite characters. Oh, now it's slippery. Oh good, now it's slippery and there's small platforms. Y'all ready for me to lose my last life?
Yes. I mean, no. I want you to keep playing forever until, like...
Until I get to the jungle-to-jungle level. That's Jungle Book, right? Okay, so here's a problem with this game I haven't mentioned before. When you jump and land... He's in this... Okay, oh my god, he has a unique frame for that. That's different from his duck sprite.
Anyway!
When he's in this particular frame, if you try to push the jump button, the game will eat your input. You will not be able to jump until he has recovered from whatever he's suffering from right now. Like, look at this. Look, the duck looks different. But...
He's got IBS. I'm so sorry, Baloo. That shit sucks.
And that's a particular problem when you're on small platforms and also sliding across them, because you want to push that jump as soon as possible so you don't slide off. And yet, you need to wait. Otherwise, your input will be eaten. This game has found a new way to annoy me. I didn't think that was possible.
I'm impressed. Honestly, I'm impressed by how pissed off I am at this game.
Yeah. Boy, those Radiant Software boys, they knew how to do it. There, easy. Fuck!
I'm so sorry for laughing at your misery. You are a saint for playing this much of this game. You really are.
I have played more of this than most other people who have loaded this ROM have played it. Most people quit on the first level. They know better. Alright, last life. This is it. The playthrough might end here unless I do this part perfectly.
I believe in you.
And then beat the game afterwards.
I think it's...
Nine, 10, 11. And that's the furthest anyone can possibly get in Tailspin for the TurboGrafx-16. Yeah, I gotta say that much. Oh, boy. Woof.
Well,
is all I gotta say to that. Alright, we're entering judgment time, but before that, I gotta find some music. Give one final good thought about what you thought about tonight's games, because we're about to rank them, and these are permanent. We can't take it back.
Mm-mm.
Now, which TurboGrafx game got that good music? That's right. China Warrior.
Oh, God. People like play Camp California. Oh, God. Multiple people want to hear Camp California, but...
That's licensed. We're running up against Mike Love if we do that.
I don't want to deal with him.
We have now entered the Hall of Judgment. Get ready to judge. Based on what you've seen tonight, are these games better or worse than Bubsy Claws Encounters of the Furred Kind for Super Nintendo and Genesis? Make your voice heard. When I mention each game, give us an RP Angel Bubsy or an RP Devil Bubsy to indicate whether you want to send these games to heaven or hell. Ah, this game has a demo. Whatever.
Whatever.
Tailspin pissed me off. I've entered, like, nihilist mode now. Just
damn.
Like, nothing matters. Who gives a shit? Alright, so back to better times. The first game we played, and somehow one credit cleared tonight, was Camp California. Is Camp California, featuring the official mascots of the Beach Boys, better or worse than Bubsy? And do keep in mind that we are also ranking Shapeshifter.
Oh boy. I am seeing a lot of angels. Wow. Wow, really? Really?
That's a surprise. I thought that game made a pretty poor showing with the public, but apparently it won them over after I showed off every bit of the game.
I think people really like Screamer.
You know what? Here's a secret. I also think it's better than Bubsy. I had a decent amount of fun with it. You can beat it pretty quickly. It's got that odd, canceled cartoon sort of vibe to it, that mm-hmm. aesthetic. Mostly because it is. It was based on a canceled cartoon. And yeah, I agree. It was decently fun, and I'd say better than Bubsy.
You know what? I think so too.
Now, I wouldn't put it far above Bubsy. Now, where are we thinking here?
Oh, well, let's see.
Ooh, I wonder if it's better than Keith Courage.
Thank you for reminding me of Rattnagel. It's better than Bubsy. I don't know how I have, like, selective Rattnagel I can't remember Rattnagel, but every time someone brings it up, my brain just latches onto it like a child. Okay, yeah, Rattnagel definitely better than Bubsy.
Yeah, for sure.
Better or worse than Bongo? Worse than Bongo. Sorry.
I don't know.
Oh, wow.
I'm actually... That's a pretty good marker for quality there. I'm kind of conflicted. I think it was better than Pandemonium.
It was.
What I want to do, what do y'all think about above Keith Courage, below the Lion King?
Wow.
Oh, Alex is not a fan.
Okay, above Castlevania Adventure. That's pretty far down. Okay, some folks are okay with that. Okay.
Let's do it. Put her there.
I kind of prefer Keith Courage.
Do you?
I think it controls better.
Are you pulling the gatekeeper card?
No, I don't believe in gatekeeping.
You get to block one ranking every year. That's the rules.
I do, but you know what? I'm going to go with this because I really like the Beach Boys.
Okay.
I've been listening to a lot of Pet Sounds lately. It's good. And also...
But consider this. Consider what's happening now. We're ranking an Icon platformer above Bubsy. They finally did it. All these platformers we've ranked, the Ghost Manners, the the Death Valley rallies. None of them could manage that. Camp California is the first.
What would you call the system since it's on the CD? Oh, is it not PC Engine CD? It's Turbo CD?
I don't know if it matters. I would just put PC Engine.
Captain Nihilist!
Again, that. Yeah. I would just put PC Engine CD.
Okay.
If you wanted to be proper, it would be TurboGrafx-16 Super CD-ROM, which is way too long.
We can fix that later, right?
When or TurboDuo. It whatever works.
Turbo CD? Just fucking Turbo CD actually works for
Do
me.
Do Turbo CD.
Thank you. All right. Good. Hold on. Where's that info? Okay. TTI Publisher, developed by ICOM.
Good old ICOM. They finally did it. I'm so proud of them. Their very last platformer, they finally managed to beat the Bubsy line. They crossed the Bubsy Meridian. Moving on to another ICOM classic, we had a game called Shapeshifter, aka Alternate Beast. ICOM's take on the transformation formula. Is Shapeshifter better or worse than Bubsy? Cast your votes. Keep in mind that Panther segment, especially. Because I thought the Barbarian was okay, and then they gave you control over another creature, and ooh boy. Unfortunately, there's multiple segments through the game where you have to be that panther, and it's impossible to control. That one mechanic just brings the whole game to a standstill. Like, I think if you hack that out, it would be a way better game. But as it is, it's incredibly frustrating, and yeah, the people seem to agree.
Yeah, some folks are like, let's see, Family Consumer has a soft spot for it, but they also remember the panther sequences in.
Yeah. It has its elements. The cutscene graphics were pretty nice. The soundtrack was god-awful, let's not mention that. Up until the Panther, I thought it was just okay. I thought it was Bubsy equivalent. Then the Panther came in, and it's like, nope, Devil Bubsy all the way. So where are we ranking this?
Well, I'd like to rank it... Da, 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 da.
Well, I'd like to rank it... Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do-do.
All right, is it better than Magic Boy?
Oh, Magic Boy was kind of a turd.
Below Alex Kidd. I actually agree it shouldn't be higher than Alex Kidd.
I don't want to rank this too low. It did have good parts, and if you get past the Panther, it's honestly not a terrible playthrough. I'm thinking around the whole Chester Cheetah range, Too Cool to Fool.
Okay, like between, let's say between Bravo Man and Donald Land.
Okay. Folks, where are we putting this? I think Mylon's Secret Castle was better.
Mm-hmm.
I think Bravo Man was... Oh, that's actually tough to say.
Yeah, I'm seeing just below Bravo Man.
I think that might be a good spot for it.
You know what? I think that... Let's see. We're also seeing between Chester and Marsupilami. That's actually a good spot, too.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's true. Bravo Man does have I'm Dr. Bomb, which is pretty fucking good.
Honestly, I think Chester Cheetah was probably worse. It was a very jank adver game that didn't have much to offer. Shapeshifter at least had ambition. You can't say that it didn't have that.
It had a lot of fucking ambition, yeah.
Let's rank it between Bravo Man and Psychic World.
I think that's a good spot for it.
Yeah. Can you believe we've almost ranked all the ICOM platformers? Only got Adam's Family to go. This is a definitive ICOM ranking.
Good!
And tonight's final game, heading back to the old Hue card, the Turbo Chip. Tailspin, a game that refused to work, and now we've played it. What do we think about it? Is it better or worse than Bubsy?
I'm seeing some devils. And a link to an image that I will click on, please. Thank you.
There was a great war? Oh my god.
Devil, 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 Bubsy, 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 squirt, 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 squirt. Thanks, 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 thanks.
Yeah, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that was tonight's worst game, by far. Mm-hmm. Like, Shapeshifter left me conflicted. I am not conflicted with how I feel about Tailspin. That game has control problems. It's just very frustrating, and it invents new ways to frustrate you in every level. Somehow you passed the first frustrating moment by taking an alternate route. I'm very impressed by that, but we managed to hit a lot of trouble spots. Ending in an ice level with tiny platforms which you had to jump over 14 of them in a row and then do an impossible jump at the end.
Hooray!
Good stuff.
Love it.
Scroll to the bottom of that list. I don't think it'll be at the bottom, but I want to see where Darkwing Duck
compares. It's not worse than Darkwing Duck. I'm just going to fucking say it. It's not worse than Darkwing Duck.
Yeah.
I could not get past any of Darkwing Duck. I could at least move forward, and I beat a whole fucking level.
You beat a level? I managed to get to the last one? Yeah, it's decently... I wouldn't say playable, but it's able to be played, which is distinct from playable.
Do you think it's better than A Week of Garfield?
Ooh, good comparison. That's a good one. Yeah, those are both licensed games with extreme quality issues. Both seem extremely behind the times. I'd say Tailspin does a better job of referencing its source material, though.
It does.
Oh, how about Ghost Manor? Let's put it up against an ICOM classic right there. Oh, God. What was less fun, Ghost Manor or Tailspin? Ghost Manor was that game where you were constantly falling down slopes and hitting the bottom of a level. Mm-hmm. Then climbing up to the top and sliding down again.
I didn't do much sliding and I didn't get put back as much in Tailspin compared to a lot of the other games. Like, especially compared to like, Shapeshifter.
Okay. I'd say better than Ghost Manor.
Yeah.
People say above Awesome Possum, that's an easy call to make.
Yeah, definitely.
Maybe around the Spider-Man X-Men Arcade's Revenge area. That game was also frustrating in a number of creative ways. I would say Spider-Man has the edge, though, just because of the Tim Fallon soundtrack. Or Jeff Fallon, rather.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Worse than Doraemon. Let's see. Below Spider-Man X-Men. Okay.
Okay, proposal. Between Spider-Man X-Men and Wizards and Warriors X.
Oh, someone already suggested that, so we're going to take your suggestion.
Wizards and Warriors and X was a turd sandwich. Nothing good about that game. No. Spider-Man had a few elements that put it above Tailspin, I think. And yeah, put that in.
All right.
I would also say Tailspin is a little bit better than Wild Woody, but most things are. Well, good work, Radiance. You managed to not make another game be at the bottom of the list.
Hurrah.
You only have one game there.
NEC and Radiance plus, whatchamacallit.
Good old Radiance. Wonder if they made any more platformers. We gotta play those.
Radiance Software and Interactive Designs. Great name.
What a team.
They're two of a kind.
And there we go. Three more TurboGrafx-16 platformers ranked for your pleasure. We did it.
Don't say it like that.
Ranked for your, eludification.
Yes, you're a ludo-narrative, cognitive, Tailspin.
Also, Squirt. It's the weekend, everyone. Welcome. Oh, we made it,
man.
Despite everything.
Ow!
Despite Baloo and his coconuts, despite Camp California and all those horrible birds, we made it to the weekend. So feel free to enjoy it as you see fit. If you want, check out Camp California. I would like some competition for a speedrun.
Yeah.
I'd be willing to moderate the speedrun.com Camp California page if there's some actual interest.
Yeah.
Just use the route I showed you tonight and do your best. And be patient. That's the most advice I can give you.
I am seeing the word squirt so much. Can we wrap up?
We better wrap up.
Before it gets out of control. Oh, this is off any
rails. We're Retro Pals. Thanks for watching. Patrons and those who wish to join our exclusive club, head to patreon.com/retropals, pitch in $5 a month, you'll get access to this week's poll. This week's poll is a simple one. I ask you one question with two choices. Which do you prefer, cats or dogs?
Ooh.
Vote for whichever, and I have a killer lineup in mind for whatever wins. Y'all don't even know. Hell, I don't even know. Some of these games I never played, but they just sound amazing, so it'll be a good time no matter what. It's also a dead heat right now from last time I checked, so you have a chance to really influence the poll, make your favorite animal be the winner, or whatever. I gotta wrap this up.
Right.
I'll look for a host. Alex, tell the folks some stuff.
All right, we're also on YouTube at youtube.com/retropals. You can catch highlights of our streams there. You can catch original scripted material. We have a series called Nintendo 64 Chronicles. It has a new episode in the works, so subscribe there if you want to see that. And also you can see music we've uploaded, like the Cats DS, which has the most amazing, amazing comments of all time.
It does. Every couple days I get a new most amazing comment on the Cats DS video.
It's so good.
Real funny. Like, I just get a notification on my tablet that says I got a comment, and someone says, damn, didn't know they went this hard.
Mostly it's people being like, this song make me so sad.
Yeah,
that too. I think one person mentioned that every Christmas they put this song on and the entire family just meows along to it.
I don't even know if that's true, but that's a weird thing to even make up.
That is terrifying. You have too much power over these people, Danny.
Ooh, who do I go with?
Who?
Who do I go with?
Humst.
Okay, so Chubo is playing some stuff on his C64. Including something called, it's just called Medieval Adventure. That's what it's called. That game has great imagination, I can just tell.
Perfect.
If you want an alternate take, you can go to Ty Tuesday, who is playing Deadliest Catch, a game that I'm so curious to try. Someday I'll play that. Someday.
You have to.
So you can check that out if you like, but I think we're going to go with Chubo.
Okay.
Go enjoy some dopey old adventure games, he says, on the Commodore 64. That should be a fun time. Yeah, week's over. Enjoy the weekend. Thanks for watching. We'll see you later.
See ya, folks.